For years, we've seen the women of the Real Housewives of New York City navigate their fancy homes, bustling social lives, and complex relationships. And now, with the end of season 11, it's really no different. Everyone, please give a warm build brunch welcome to Luann De Lesseps and Sonja Morgan.
Welcome.
Hello.
Hi, welcome. So you're here.
Oh, how are you?
Hi, George.
Banner.
Carrie.
Hi, Sonja.
Hi.
Guys, these are my
Hi,
queens
everybody.
Right here.
Queens
like, hello,
are here.
Can we bow down for a second? Woo! Okay, we gotta get right into it because I'm assuming everybody here has already seen part one of the reunion. A lot happened, yes. But I have to say, Sonja, we saw you playing a role I've never seen you play. You were really the peacemaker of this first part, at least.
Well, I'm in the middle mm-hmm. of my dearest friend, Luann. We've been friends forever. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, Dorinda, I was like starting to see her side because Luann was in self-protection mode, mm-hmm. you know, protecting her sobriety and herself, which came off very self-centered. And mm-hmm. we felt we were being treated like crap.
Yeah, I was gonna say for you.
You don't have time to do it all sometimes, yeah. Which is, you know, I had to remove myself from certain situations just to take care of me. And I think that came off as being, you know, self-centered, but the reality is that I had to really work at it, and it wasn't mm-hmm. easy, and I think that might have looked insensitive to them,
yeah.
But I just didn't have it to give.
You had to yeah. protect you know yourself.
Mean? Yeah, exactly.
And that gave me time with Dorinda yeah. to bond with her and hold her hand, because Luann didn't need us. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. She needed to be by herself and be immersed in her cabaret.
No, I always need you, Sonja.
No, you didn't.
I always
need you.
Yeah.
You said it best.
That's
but
true.
But I think between the two of you also, there was an interesting dynamic because Sonja, you are a bit of a party girl.
Which, yes.
Please never stop. But I mean, for you, it's probably so interesting going into the season not drinking. Mm-hmm. And Sonja, on the other side of that, what do you think the show would be like without any drinking? Because, like, all the drama comes out when these ladies got a drink in them.
Oh, you know what? Luann's never been funnier. You know, when she's not drinking, she's funny. And I didn't drink for a couple of several seasons. Mm-hmm. And I remember Luann saying, oh, come on, Sonja, have a drink. Come on. Yeah, there's no drinking business. And now it's flip-flopped.
Yeah.
So we go through different periods because Luann doesn't have a problem when she's drinking. She's great. Mm-hmm. It's just this period of time she's not drinking. Because mm-hmm. remember, she had a wooden leg before. Yeah. I couldn't keep up with her.
That's so, true. Really. I only fell into a bush once.
Yeah.
In 11 years.
And right? gracefully.
And gracefully, right?
We just go through periods of time in our life where we say, we're going to pull back now. Mm-hmm. Now, after what happened to me in Miami,
oh, yeah.
I was like, geez.
The those fall heard around the
floors,
world.
Those Miami Vice houses do not work. I like the Berkshire's soft corners,
yeah.
soft cushions. You, know?
You need a bush, well, like Luann.
Yeah,
I need
exactly.
my snatch guard.
You lived in a world where Clinton was president. It was a
yeah.
dream world a little
well,
bit.
Well, I was being funny.
I loved it.
I was being very funny there, you know, and my Trump joke. And, you know, I just like to be very funny. I love to get a reaction out
yeah.
of people.
Yeah.
Especially I mean, tins.
That is
well, we, you know, we like to have a good time, and I think that's part of the appeal is that, you know, people get to lose themselves in our lives, and I think they can relate. You know, yeah. everybody's had their night where they fell into a bush, right?
Yes. Or under so, a table.
No shame yeah, for like that.
Honestly, both have it
yeah,
to me.
Thank and you.
I got to say that, you know, we're old friends, and I think you can really see that on The Housewives of New York, and that's mm-hmm. what makes the franchise so good, is that we have real friendships. They're not, you know, mm-hmm. made up, and there's a dynamic there. We're all very different women, and mm-hmm. I think that's what makes the show work. You know, yeah. we all have big personalities.
What I love is we all grow through the show and evolve, and when the chips are down, we're there for each other, and we have no problem. We both lived in Europe, so we love to just vent and move on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Luann just moves on better than anyone.
Yeah.
She's like, yeah. what? Are you divorced, Sonja? Yes, I'm divorced.
On that note of evolution what? And of friendships, of course, Sonja, people love watching the relationship between you and Ramona. It is a sisterhood. You're two now single women out on the town. But also, I mean, you kind of call her out. You know, when you point out a Ramona apology coming out of nowhere. So why do you think, what's make your relationship so special with her?
You know, I have more tolerance for Ramona than I would say Luann does. But
that's true.
The singer stinger.
I think than most people do.
Yeah. Yeah.
She got caught in so many lies this year that even I yeah. couldn't stand up for her. And we're like sisters. We just are. And she's the itch I cannot scratch. Mm-hmm. You know, just when I think it's gone, it's like poison ivy. It's there. I just, I love her, and I understand her, and I know what she's been through. I think this season was interesting where her and Bethany got on the same page about growing up the way they did.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That was interesting to me, and I've known it all along.
Right.
But sometimes you can't use it as an excuse. Mm-hmm.
And since Luann, you mentioned the show's been on for 11 seasons. It is one of the most successful shows of the franchise. And I've watched it since day one. And, you know, we had this middle area. And then when Bethany came back, kind of seemed like a revitalization of the show, kind of getting back to its original DNA. Do you think her return, kind of restoring the original relationships, was a big part of keeping the show on now for so long?
I
don't think so. I think we were doing it.
Well, Bethany was gone for years.
Yeah,
and
we
managed
we're fine.
To carry the show.
Right, yeah.
You know, so obviously, you know, Bethany's a big character, and it's great to have her back. But, you know.
What the hell are you talking about?
Yeah, what are you talking about?
No, this is what I'm saying.
Lucas, have you lost your mind?
No.
Have you lost your mind?
Luann and I both emailed Bethany and said, we're so happy you're coming back. And gosh, we do feel it as the DNA is back or whatever, mm-hmm. as you said.
That's
but what was the other thing you said? Do you think that's the reason the show has lasted as long as the Real Housewives of New York City? Ramona Singer will be in diapers and a wheelchair.
Bethany. This is what I meant. Not Bethany. What makes the show so unique is what Luann was talking about, the authentic relationship.
That's right.
And that's mm-hmm. what it was about. Like, when I watched this day one, the five women, and you came on season three, which, of course, when the show blew up. But you guys are...
He's trying to repair it.
Ramonicizing it.
I'm pulling up out of her playbook. I watch a lot of Housewives, so it makes New York so special. You guys are real friends. Mm-hmm. You guys are really...
Each characters, you know, each one of us are... You broke
Well, there's a history there, you know. Obviously, there's a history, and it's... You know, it's like watching a discombobulated family of sorts, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
where the housewives kind of discombobulated family that at the end of the day, we have to sit down at Thanksgiving dinner and get along.
So
that's what's interesting is the dynamic.
But without the show, we would too, because we do care about each other. We have a history. I was friends with Ramona for decades.
Right.
I was friends for almost 10 years with Luann before the show. I knew Tinsley forever. I knew Bethany before the show. I knew mm-hmm. Jill before the show.
Okay,
I didn't
we've
know
established
Alex.
We have history.
Yeah, she's like, and let me go through but every then, single person.
But then does it hurt more, though? Does it hurt more when you fight with Dorinda because you guys have it, a friend? Does it hurt more when you fight with Ramona because this is not
I think it does. If it's somebody that you don't care about, then you don't care.
Yeah. Right.
You know what I mean? And I think that what's real about it is, like you fight with a sibling,
mm-hmm.
you know? You fight, and then you make up because you know you have to be together. You are a family, and you know, and blood is thicker than water.
Well, how did you feel when Dorinda and Luann were fighting? I was so worried.
So sad.
That hug during part one was
love that. That was such. A,
Me
I'm so
too.
Glad you got up and did that. I was like, thank God.
Yeah.
And Sonja gave her props too.
Yes.
I was like,
yeah. Sonja was good. She was.
Sonja was great.
Was very good.
I want Sonja reunion part
with
one.
Carol. What happened with Carol and Bethany, mm-hmm. I was so mm-hmm. worried for Luann and Dorinda. I just didn't want to see that happen. Because you guys were real friends.
No, you know, I knew that we would repair our friendship. Mm-hmm. It just took a minute. You know, when you get hurt sometimes, you know, you have to let the scab heal, you know, and that's how it felt. And then it was time to rip the Band-Aid off.
Right.
Yeah.
And of course, like you said, Ramona will be on the show when she's in diapers. I'm sure you all will be.
Oh, please. We're not going to be.
Yeah, I'm sure we're all being diapers.
Let's not hope for diapers.
I'm still in diapers.
No.
No, but I also love the way I had some time to bond with Dorinda since mm-hmm. they were so close because we're going through the same things right now. I scaled down to my 2-bedroom apartment on Columbus Circle with pink walls, blue walls, and little fireplace.
And towels for curtains.
Towels for curtains.
And then towels for curtains.
I love it.
And my townhouse.
I love that scene.
With the monogram.
And my townhouse was rented, and now it's available again because my last renter moved out in June, so.
That's so incredible. We've seen you guys go on journeys.
So you've heard it here first. Sonja Morgan's townhouse is for rent, okay?
I heard, how much did you say?
Well, it was $32,000, and then the last renter was $36,000, but I'm flexible. Well,
that makes me so happy.
Wait, are any...
For long-term renters.
Are any of these renters going to make an appearance?
Their mouths are agape. $36,000, yes, per month. That is per month.
When you guys began on the show, I think you guys were in very different stages of your life. Like, Luann, mm-hmm. you were married, you were Countess. Sonja, you were just getting out of a marriage. You were a single mom, still are, but you guys now are businesswomen. Sonja Morgan, New York, you have a cabaret, you're touring literally around the country. I've had all my friends go to your shows.
Thank you.
Could you ever have imagined where you guys started to where you guys are now in your lives?
Well, you know, we've had both very rich lives. Mm-hmm. Not literally, but
literally.
Maybe. Full lives, yeah.
But we both have had full lives and, you know, lived in Europe and traveled a lot. And so, you know, it's kind of a great extension of our lives. I always say that, you know, I watched season two the other day, mm-hmm. and I was like, oh, my God. You know, it's really a living photo album of our lives. Right. And we're lucky to have that. Like, for instance, my house in Bridgehampton doesn't exist anymore. Yeah.
Can you believe it?
And that's on the show. Wow. And I got to see it the other night. And it was like, oh, my God, I had such wonderful memories.
And the first time I was on Watch Albums Live with Luann, I said, she's really great at Broadway hits. You remember that?
Yes.
And now she's doing cabaret.
Yeah.
I always knew that was your
So Sonia's also a psychic.
Yes,
Sonia's
I am.
A psychic.
Well, I have a Pisces moon.
Well, you know, she loves her psychics.
I'm intuitive.
Yeah. She loves her
I love
psychics.
My astrology, too.
Yes.
I mean, I just got to say, Feelin' Giovanni is already the hit
Great
of the
song.
Summer.
Hit of the summer.
Oh, my God.
Hit of the summer.
Are you guys playing this today? No.
Yes.
Great song. All your songs
Thank
are great.
You.
And
Thank
your,
you,
and your jewelry is beautiful.
Thank
but
you.
But the thing is, with Dorinda, you just really cannot bring up Giovanni around her yet.
Okay.
She doesn't like it.
I told her to let it go. I did. I said, let it go.
Well, I just have to say this. I asked Dorinda, because of course when the song was coming out, I asked her, mm-hmm. you know, if she would like to be in the music video.
You united the coast.
You didn't ask you me, which coast. I, that's
Well,
I,
it made sense for Dorinda, my
okay,
love.
Okay, well,
of
what
course,
makes sense is I did all those shows with you. I
and you were great.
Oh, no.
And
you
don't owns need the to be in the video.
No.
Okay, season 12 coming up.
No.
Coming up. I love your
season. Huge start
oh,
on this
no.
show.
Oh, no. Here we go. No, so, you know, I asked her to be in the music
Which
video,
nice.
And then I asked her to come to the launch for the song, et cetera.
Mm-hmm. Of course, she said no.
She politely declined, but mm-hmm.
I would have declined, too.
That's fine. I find, you know, it was nice to change the narrative and make it happy, and that's
totally.
What I did with the song.
You made so, it, you tried to bring
I made it
the
light. I made light of a
you didn't make
otherwise
it
nice. Difficult situation.
You had two other girls in it. But it's a great song.
Great
Thank
song.
You guys so much for joining us.